Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. Today in this video we are going to discuss about few important topics. First, dielectric constant, after that polarization, and in the last part of the video we will discuss what is the relation of electric displacement vector with electric field and polarization. Okay, so let us see. First of all, what is dielectric material? Because before going to discuss dielectric constant, we should know what is dielectric material. We start from very basic. You know, on the basis of electricity, materials can be divided into three categories. First, conductor, second, insulator, and third, semiconductor. You know already, conductors are those materials through which current can pass easily. Conductors have large number of free electrons, so current passes. In semiconductor, neither it is a good conductor nor a good insulator. But our attention is not on conductor and semiconductor. We will focus on insulators. Insulators are those materials through which current does not pass because electrons are tightly bound with the nucleus. There are no free electrons. But application of electric field means when we apply large electric field, we can modify the behavior of insulator. Okay? And those insulators are called dielectrics. So one thing you have to remember, that dielectric materials means mostly insulators. Most of the insulators are dielectric materials. Okay, so you can see here, dielectric materials are also called insulators. In dielectric materials, all the electrons are tightly bound to their parent molecules and there are no free charges. Dielectrics are non-metallic materials of high specific resistance and negative temperature coefficient of resistance. They have permanent magnetic dipole moment. Examples are mica, glass, plastic, water, polar molecules. So now I think what is dielectric material, it is clear. So next part we will discuss what is dielectric constant. But to know about dielectric constant, first we consider a parallel plate capacitor. As you know, in a capacitor there are two plates. You can see in figure 1A, there are two plates here. Upper plate having charge minus, so it, here I have written minus sigma free charge density. Actually, if we take the area A, then its charge per unit area is called charge density. And here, free, you can see sigma free. Why free? Because these charges are free. Okay? And when we talk about lower plate, here's plus sigma free. Because plus charge. The electric, due to these two charges, electric field between the two plates is zero, whose direction is from lower plate to upper plate, means from positive to negative charge. And this electric field is denoted by E0. E0 is equal to sigma free by epsilon zero. Here epsilon zero is the permittivity of air or vacuum, because there is no any medium between the two plates. either air or even air is not present, maybe vacuum. So electric field E0 having direction from lower plate to upper plate. This is your equation one. Now, see here. We are going to discuss when we insert dielectric material between the two plates. You can see here. This is the dielectric material. Okay. This is the dielectric material which is inserted between the two plates. As soon as dielectric material is placed here, what happens? A layer of positive charges are displaced towards negative plate, means upper plate, and layer of negative charges are displaced towards positive plate, that is lower plate. So positive charges are deposited on the surface here, negatives are deposited on the surface here. E0 is equal to sigma free by epsilon 0, as I discussed. Now, these charges are bound charges here, because these charges are deposited on the surface due to polarization. This phenomenon is non-polarization, known as polarization. Okay. So when the space between the capital filled with dielectric polarization, charge develops positive on the upper surface, negative on the lower surface, giving rise to bound polarization charge density sigma p and polarization per unit volume. The polarization electric field Ep is equal to sigma p by epsilon 0, and you may write minus p by epsilon 0. Here p is the polarization. And one thing you will notice here, E0 was already there from lower plate to upper plate, but this Ep, polarizing electric field, is from upper to lower. Okay, and this decreases the strength of E0, because Ep is opposite to E0, and that is why we write E is equal to E0 minus P by epsilon 0. Okay, and here it is epsilon 0 taking LCM and multiplying cross multiplication epsilon 0 E, and this part is taken left side, so epsilon 0 equals P. And this will be here, epsilon 0 E0. And epsilon 0 E0 is called electric displacement vector. So we write P is equal to epsilon 0 E plus P. Actually, we have to deduce this relation. We have to derive this relation. Okay. I think you have understood this part. So, and here all have in the same direction. You may see here vector notation. But D, E, E0, P all have in the same direction. So we may leave it, and in simple we may write D is equal to epsilon 0 E plus P. Here it will be E plus. Actually this one. By mistake, here E0, suffix 0 is used here. Actually it will not be here. So correct it. You have to understand this part. Now, suppose you wish to define dielectric constant. You may write it is the ratio of epsilon by epsilon 0. What is epsilon? Permittivity of the medium placed between the two plates, and epsilon 0 is the permittivity of air or vacuum. You may take another definition also. You may call alternative definition in terms of capacitance. So if the C is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor with dielectric, and C0 is the capacity of parallel plate capacitor without dielectric, then this ratio is called relative permittivity or dielectric constant denoted by epsilon of K. Now we are going to define polarization. As I told you, when dielectric material is inserted between the plates, there is separation of charges. Positive charges are displaced toward negative plate. Negative charges are deposited on the surface of dielectric material towards opposite charge plate. And due to this separation, we may name the phenomenon polarization. So polarization is actually mathematically we define polarization as dipole moment per unit volume of the material. Polarization P is defined as dipole moment per unit volume of the material. And the due to when we introduce the dielectric material, what happens? The electric field E0 is reduced by factor EP, and the net E field becomes E is equal to E0 minus EP. Okay. I hope you have understood the topic. In the next video, we will discuss the same topic, dielectric constant polarization, in short, because already we have discussed here. But the main focus will remain on frequency dependence of polarizability. This is the main question, which is very important from the examination point of view for degree 3 student. So I will discuss in the next video. Thank you.